Oops, I accidentally hit the button. We're a little early because I accidentally hit the button. just reflex. But welcome, everybody, to another episode of, well, today's Yankees Even Sicker Today live gun chat because I feel worse today than I did yesterday. I have spent most of my day sweating my ass off and can't hardly talk. Coughing my head off. Hopefully I won't cough much during the video. Had a hell of a time getting my video ready today. I was an hour late getting it up because it took so long to film it. But I feel worse today than I did yesterday. Hopefully I'll feel better tomorrow. I slept 10 hours last night. Wasn't good sleep. It was really bad sleep where you toss and turn and wake up every 20 minutes, but it was 10 hours long. I went to bed at 1 o'clock, didn't get up till 11. but let's get started here. Welcome, everybody, to Yankees. Well, like I said, it's Even Sicker Today live chat. If you've never been here before, this is just a conversation between myself and my viewers. Although you don't have to talk to me, you can talk amongst yourselves over there in the live chat. It's a place you can come every day for about an hour and have conversations with like-minded individuals about common interests. But if you do want to talk to me, that's why I'm here. So you can ask me questions, so you can suggest topics, so you can call me out if you think I've been wrong about something. feel free to do so. You can even come in the chat and let me know what I've been wrong about if you would like to. All you got to do is let me know you want to come in. All you got to have is a microphone. You don't even have to have a camera. if you want to ask me questions or do any of that, all you got to do is put at the Yankee Marshall, like it says right here, at the front of your question or comment so I can actually see it and hopefully answer it. Can't promise I'll see them because it takes me a while to get to them, which means sometimes we run out of time before I run out of questions because I'm quite a bit behind in the chat usually. So don't repeat chats, though. If you put a chat in there and I don't see it yet, don't repeat it because it makes me have a hard time finding where I'm at when I have to go back up and look. Because I see a question I already answered. I think, well, I've already been up this high and blah, blah, blah. So don't repeat questions. Put at the Yankee Marshall in front of them. I'll try to get to all of them. If you've got a question or a comment you don't want to wait to see if I get to, you want to jump to the front of the line as far as being answered, you could do a super chat. Super chats get priority as far as being answered. I'm going to try to make the whole hour tonight, by the way. We'll see. But super chats get priority because they are funding the Pets and Vets program. So you can do a super chat if you just want to fund Pets and Vets. That's why you'll see a lot of people just say P's and V's or Pets and Vets or Pets or Vets or whatever. so feel free to do that. Other ways you can support the Pets and Vets program and every other program we run, except for TY and Triple P, is go over and become a patron on patreon.com. Today was kind of sad because we lost 9 patrons on patreon.com today. We dropped down 9. We are now down to, let's go look over here, see active. Because remember, we got up to 784 as I was doing that fundraiser, giving away the ammo. We got 784. We didn't make it to 800, but we made it 784, which was only 6 more than we started with. But now we're down to 775. So. We dropped 9 today. I don't think there were any new ones mixed in there either. It was just everybody left. It was just everybody leaving. so if you want to go over and support the programs, go over to patreon.com. We're in desperate need of patrons to support the channel and everything it does. we got a super chat coming in from DM Faust says, just because, yeesh, you look worse than you normally do. Yeah, but for once, I can actually say I feel worse than I look. Usually, I feel a lot better than I look. People see me and like, oh my God, what's wrong? And I'm like, I don't know, I'm fine. But today, I look bad and I feel worse. I feel worse than yesterday, that's for sure. I didn't even eat dinner last night. I felt so bad. It takes a lot to make me not eat dinner. DM Faust also gifted a membership, although I don't know who got it. Who got it? Mike Lewis got it. Teddy Two Guns just put a Gen 5 Glock 20 on hold. Hopefully my check will be good. I already pulled 600 out, though. Well, that's a good gun. I like mine. I'm very fond of mine. My favorite Glock I've ever owned, I will have to say. Excuse the coughing and the clearing of the throat. Cam Gaylord Outdoors says, I currently have COVID. I bet you caught it from me in your comment section. Maybe. I hope not. Pretty sure I got it from those little snot lickers that were here visiting all week. My great niece and great nephew. Because my great nephew, he took a real liking to me. So he always wanted me to carry him. He always wanted me to put him on my shoulders. And when we were sitting on the couch, he would come over and just lean on my shoulder and lean over and talk to me right in my face, which is something five-year-olds do. Caden used to do that. But, yeah, they're the ones that made me sick, I'm pretty sure. Dale Rickety said, I got nothing. He got nothing to add nothing to add to the chat. I've put a few chats asking if you could please make a shirt with the blue line red flag that was in your video. I promised to buy at least one, but I'm sure my wife will want it as well. Thanks, auditing too. I've got it right here on my list. says right here. Where'd I put it? Blue line shirt from video. It's on my list. I just haven't done anything today, really. If we get slow later, maybe I'll do it. I got to find it first. At least, you know, do a similar thing to it. Where was that? Blue line. Contains blue. I know that's Ford Mustang blue. I don't even see it over here. I gotta find what I did with it. Oh shit, that's not what I wanted to do at all. That it disappeared. There we go. Let me try that. No, that didn't do it. Why is it so tall now? Hold on, I'm trying to get this back to where it goes. There we go. Got it back. I'll have to look it up, see if I can find it. Let's see. Do I see it over here anywhere? Did I do it on this new set of videos, or did I do it on my old? Aha, there it is right there. Let's see. Police officer, thin blue line. Let's see. See if I can find it under that. Why can I not find this anywhere? Well, I found the actual flag, so I can make it. I just have to redo the graphic because I can't find what I did with it. all right. The other program we run, other than Pets and Vets and a Friend and Voices programs that we fund through Subscribestar, is TYMPPP. If you're a winner from last month, I have sent that off to Grab a Gun. Hopefully, they'll get those out soon. If you are someone that registered for this month's drawing, meaning you registered last month, your stuff is with the judges, and we will announce that on the 15th. If you're someone that needs to register now, you can go over and register. You'll be in next month's drawing. So feel free to go over to tympistolproject.com and register. If you're someone who doesn't need to benefit from TYMPPP, but you'd like to support it, go on over and become a Subscribestar supporter or buy merch. We got lots of merch over there. Here, I got a link to the merch. I'll put it, a link to the merch here. I'll put it over in the live chat. This is listed by date of when it was added, so you should be able to find the new stuff quite easily. Although there's some stuff at the top that isn't actually new, but I had to redo it because it wasn't getting printed at the other place. I think I'm done with the spiel. Let me go over and read people who have bought merchandise so I can say thank you to anyone who's made a purchase today. Let's see. Do we got any from today? I don't know if we do or not. Let's see. Let me get signed in. Andrew Ragus, that was from yesterday. Why is that showing up? Andrew Jinx, that was from yesterday. I don't know why that's showing up under today's. Let me go over to this one. Well, it looks like we got one from today. We got a 2024 ballot mug from Alan Glazer. That looks like the only order from today. Wait, hold on. Yeah, that's the only order from today. So I don't know why those two are showing up. So no, not doing very well today. But we had a couple good days the past few days, so that's not too bad. excuse me. All righty, let's get over here and see if there's any questions. But thanks to those people, that person, for buying merchandise and helping support TY and Triple P. Let me get back over here to the live chat, see if there's anything coming in. Good evening, ye old fart et. They put the et tonight. They didn't last night. Sent you an email with Jaxie the cat. I saw that. Where did it go? I saw it over here. It was military surplus stuff. Where did it go? Or police trade-ins. That's what it was. Yeah, there we go. Where's Jax? Why can I not get this to show? There we go. I'm trying to get it to where you can see the cat and the guns. There we go. But he sent me this here picture here. His cat Jaxie and a couple of police trade-ins he's recently purchased, I assume. One on the left looks a little rough. One on the right looks like it's almost new. Let's see here. Usually I ask what's for dinner. Judging on you being sick, I'm guessing some kind of super broth. If I eat anything. I don't know if I'll eat anything for dinner. I didn't eat last night. And today I've just had grapes and oranges. I sent you more emails. Enjoy. I saw that one about the female cops and what about the sex abuse charges. I became a supporter yesterday. Oh, did you go through Subscribestar? Hold on, let me see. Maybe that'll put us back up near 100. Where's supporters? Subscribers, right there. Nope, we're down. We're down to 95 now, so I don't see. We must have lost a couple if you became one. Let's see. Subscribed. Well, not my last subscriber was 328. Let me see over on Patreon. I don't think I saw any over there. No, I didn't get any new subscribers on Patreon yesterday. Did you maybe become a channel member? Is that what it is? Do you have a little icon after your name? I can't tell. So he got a little icon after his name? Yes, he's got a little icon after his name. So that's what he did. He joined as a channel member. let's see here. I have a theory why most people overlook. Yeah, we're really down. I didn't mention it, but we're down on Subscribestar too. We've lost more. Down to 96 now. Or 95, actually. Yeah, down to 95. That is collapsing quickly. Pete Gar says, I'm sorry. As someone who is slim built, a revolver is awful for concealed carry over semi-auto. No, it's not. You just don't know how to carry it. You're not carrying at the right height or whatever. As long as you have any type of waist or hip bone, you can carry a revolver just as easily as you can semi-auto. If you know what gun to carry and how to carry it. I've seen skinny people make semi-automatics disappear as soon as they learn how. That little space right above your pelvis and right below your bottom of your rib cage right there, just boom, a gun right there disappears, revolver does. I have a theory why most people overlook even the more tactical revolvers. I'm theorizing it costs a 357 Magnum ammo or 345 Colt. Yeah, I don't think a lot of people take ammo costs into consideration when they buy guns. I think that's something they find out about later a lot of times. Mike D donated and said, because a paw needs a hand. Oh, we will be giving a t-shirt away at the end of the night, by the way. A t-shirt, a hat, or a small flag, whichever one you want. Or if you want a magnet, I'll get you a magnet. But I assume you'd want a t-shirt, a hat, or a small flag. We'll be drawing from the people who do super chats. $2 gets you one entry, $5 gets you three, $10 gets you seven, and $20 gets you 15. And if you want to donate more than 20, go to Patreon and donate. I get to keep more of it that way. we get to spend it more on the actual programs we run instead of giving it to YouTube. A photo to help you feel better. Hold on. She must have an iPhone because it's an HEIC file. Oh, look at that. Oh, my goodness. Let's see. Can I make that show up as a picture? Because for some reason, it launched in my GIMP program, which is a graphics program for people who don't know. Let's see if I can share that. Present, share screen, Winder. Look at that little baby. Oh, my God. Look at that little baby. Reminds me of a turnip with a little baby. Oh, I need that. That does make me feel a little bit. Why did that not close? Discard changes. There we go. let's see. Where are we? I can relate. I was playing with my niece and my knees hurt. What's your current EDC? How did the Super Alaskan work this winter? The Super Alaskan was great. I still carry it sometimes if I'm just going to be up in the woods or hiking or something. But mostly lately, I've been carrying the 2.5-inch Python. Sometimes cross draw, sometimes strong side. When would you think a 9mm pistol would be the gun of choice, if not the only choice? I don't know. Are you trying to kill mosquitoes or something? Like pest control, like that? Or maybe take out a mouse? I don't know. Maybe then, maybe, but then I think I'd still rather have a 22 revolver. I can't think of any time a 9mm semi-auto would be best for anything. Unless you want to be laughed at by people who really like guns, then it would be best. Another theory I have why people stay away from revolvers is because most people who can shoot 9mm can't hit a target using six. Well, a lot of people can't shoot a revolver, but that's because they don't know how. We just got a new patron. So now we're only down 8 today. It was Adam Skipper. Adam Skipper. Let's see where I'm at. I'm having trouble concentrating today. I always have trouble concentrating, but it's worse today. There's not a lot of people here today. There's only 130 people in here right now. I think, though, it's because it's Wednesday, and I think we're corking never enough ammo. So I think some of the people are over there. So another small theory is people who don't carry revolvers is they think a snub nose isn't powerful for some reason. Yeah, some people don't understand that. When starting with holsters... I mean, there are times when it doesn't make sense to go up to a more powerful round in a revolver. Like if you've got like a little lightweight LCR and you put 38 special plus P's in it. Are you really going to get enough out of it to go up to the 357 mag if you can't handle the 357 mag and you won't train with it because of that? I think you should. I think you could go up to the 357 Magnum and train with 38 specials, but carry 357 Magnum. But I could understand why someone chose 38 and didn't think that it was worth going up to the 357 Magnum. It's like the little sea camps, the 38 and the 32. The 32 is less powerful than the 380. I think I said 38. The 380 and the 32, the 32 is less powerful. But the 380 is almost unusable in the little sea camp. It'll bust your fingers up. So in that case, I would stay with the smaller caliber 32. Because it will definitely bust up your fingers. Oh, that was Adam Skipper that became a channel member. Now he's a patron too. when starting with holsters, would you start with an outside waistband or just go straight for an inside waistband? I'd go with outside waistband, stay with outside waistband. When you coat a gun with Wheeler's ceramic coat, do you have to take the whole lower part or can you just bake it with trigger, etc. inside still? Well, I take it all apart. You don't want to be coating it with stuff still together, so I take it all apart. I completely detail strip the gun. I mean, there ain't nothing in there you're going to hurt if you bake it that way, but I detail strip the gun before I coat it. Because you're going to want to take it completely apart, and you're going to want to give it a bath in some sort of detergent or solvent material to get all the grease and stuff out of it. And if you leave it together and do that, you can end up with stuff that's still sticking between pieces, bleeding out during the baking process, and you don't want that to happen. So completely disassemble it, clean it exceptionally well, coat it, then bake it, and then just put it back together. Coral. Oh, that was bad. Coral. Sound like I hit puberty there for a minute. I heard about a robbery in Washougal at Limitless America Gun Shop. Do you shop there? Hope you feel better soon. I do not, because I do not like them. I don't like them. The other gun shops I know in town don't like them. They are hardcore MAGA morons, and I just don't like them. And it's not just the MAGA thing. It's just that they're really kind of assholes. So I don't go there anymore. I used to, but I just got enough of the bullshit when I was in there. Very divisive, very hateful, very, I'm just like, good God, how many customers do you probably chase out of here every day with that shit? So I'm not interested in them. And I didn't know if it was a robbery because they said nothing was stolen. I saw it on our local forum and it said that a car hit the building, but the owner said nothing was stolen. So I don't know if it was a robbery or just someone ran into the building. It'd be real easy to do coming down that road because their front door kind of faces the same way you would be coming off the road if you ran off a road. I think I got a couple orders. Let's see. We got an order from Dale Rickety. He got a Kermit ceramic mug. We got an order from Jason Thompson. Why is he sending something to Rick? He got him a mug and a magnet. I wonder if he ever got the hat. I wonder if he ever got that hat. and he also made a donation. No, wait. Yeah, he made a donation to TYMP. John Mandrick made the donation to TYMP. And Jason Thompson bought some stuff for somebody else. Good luck, America. Got him the No Bootlickers Allowed die cut magnet and ceramic mug. I don't know if he ever got the hat. I wonder if he ever got the hat that I sent him. Oops, it just jumped me to the bottom. I got to go back up. What do you think of Dragon Man, the most armed man in America? You mean the guy that's got like that big collection and stuff? Well, good for him. Doesn't he make money off like letting people tour and shoot his guns and stuff? And So I think that part of it's really awesome because people get to go shoot things and do things that they wouldn't normally get to do or see things they wouldn't normally get to see. So I'm a big fan of that. I don't know anything about the guy himself. I mean, we might get in a room. We might get into a fucking fist fight if we, you know, but where we might be best friends forever, brothers separated at birth, you know, kind of a thing. But I doubt it because I don't like most people. But I like the fact that he exists. Do you think gender dysphoria is a mental disorder? Well, gender dysphoria is a mental condition, of course. And I would personally call it a disorder. I mean, but people seem to think that disorder is a negative term. It doesn't have to be negative. Just like if something is retarded, that's not necessarily a negative thing either. I mean, it's not a derogatory thing. So if you are physically a male or physically a female, but your brain thinks you're the opposite, well, then that would be a mental disorder. That's not normal for that to happen. You're not in the majority. So I would consider, yeah, it a disorder. But I don't consider it like necessarily a horrible thing that people need to be treated for, because I don't think there's anything you can do about it. I don't think it's a treatable condition. I think it's just, it's a set mental condition. So, but yeah, I don't see why people shy away from saying, that's like when people say, oh, the being gay is not abnormal. Well, it is abnormal because 90% of the people are not gay. So only if only 10% is, then that's not the norm. It is the norm that 10% of people would be gay. So if you have a population and 10% of them are gay, well, that's normal. But as an individual being gay, you're in the 10%, not the 90. So that's not absolutely normal. and if you had like if you went to San Francisco where half the crowd is gay, well, that's abnormal too, because that's not usual. People like to assign negative meaning to words. When there's not really any negative need for a negative meaning to be there. We got another order here. Who was this? It was John Mandrick. What'd he get? He got him a Kermit mug and a 2024 mug. I think I'm dying. Then we got a new patron member. Who was this? Brigitte Fitzmorris. That can't be a real person, can it? Brigitte Fitzmorris. That's got to be an alias. Got to be like a stage name or something, like a stripper name. Or no, because if it was a stripper name, they'd call her Brigitte Fitzmorian or something, I guess. But what is the point of Beretta's Brigadier Slide? it's just beefier, stronger. Because back in the day when they horribly, horribly abused some Berettas, they had a minor breakage issue. So for the military, they said, well, we'll make you one that's a little stronger that can take that horrible, horrible abuse. It's not necessarily necessary, but if you've ever got a chance between a Brigadier and a regular one, get the Brigadier. I just think the lines are better. I like the little hoop. And plus, with the Brigadiers, you get a replaceable front sight. So I say get the Brigadiers always, every chance you get. I am going to die eventually. We all are. Been trying to break in a new to me pair of P1445. I haven't seen any of those in a long time. In with Browning Full Metal Jacket, and I can't get through 50 rounds without feeding failure. Bringing it to a gunsmith for a polish and tune. Afraid I got a stinker. Happens sometimes. If all you've tried in it is Browning Full Metal Jacket, try something else. Some guns don't like certain ammos. Try something else first, especially before you take it somewhere and pay to have something done. And something like polishing the feed ramp, stuff like that, you can do yourself at home. You don't got to take it anywhere. I've got videos on that. I would take it apart, clean it thoroughly, polish feed ramp, make sure my magazines are good. That can be a big problem, especially with those guns. I heard that they had bad magazines. So see if you can stick another magazine in it, see how they work. Because, what do you call it? Para-Ordnance, they had some magazine issues on several of their guns. So change the mag first, clean it, polish out the feed ramp first, and then take it out and shoot it with the Browning, and then shoot it with something else and see what happens, and then consider taking it to a gunsmith. There's Bosco Neptune. Haven't heard from him in a while. John Mandrick says, hope you feel better tomorrow. I hope I do too. I bet you I hope I do more than you do even. I mean, you might be a nice guy, but I hope I feel better because I'm about ready to be done with this. This is gross. I'm sick of it. My throat feels like it's on fire. If I move around, I get dizzy. I can't catch my breath. It's just been a lot of fun. I feel like I ran a marathon, except I didn't run no marathon. Rick's been sick too. He got a lot of packages too. Oh, I never get a lot of packages. I get very few packages. Fuck him. He gets all kinds of shit. I don't get nothing. I get a hat every now and then. And I got a Bigfoot birdhouse that's in my mom's room now. I ended up not putting it outside. I use it as a decoration on a table because it's too pretty to put outside. I will admit, shooting a 4DS took a little getting used to, but didn't turn me off. I mean, 4-inch Chiappa, those are awesome to shoot. I just read a statistic that 1 in 10 people in the world rely on a wheelchair to get around. I thought the figure would be much lower. Yeah, where'd you see that statistic? I don't think 10% of people are in a wheelchair. I don't buy that at all. Now, the only reason I would think that maybe they could make that statistic seem real is if they count every invalid elderly person that's in a nursing home that can't get around as being someone depending on a wheelchair to get around. But that's just invalid. I don't think that they're not getting around, period. So out of people that are actually still out around moving, going places, yeah, there's no way it's 10% of people. No way. You hit puberty when? About 20 minutes ago. If you were paying attention, you should have been paying attention. I think I'm going to start having hair where I haven't had hair before. And things are going to get bigger. But that is happening. I am getting hair where I haven't had hair before because now my ears are very hairy. I have to shave them every other day, and or at least once a week. And my shoulders are getting a little hair on right up here. And I'm like, what? Why is there hair here now? Do you think 99.4% of Americans should accept the 0.6% that are doing their best to change society to their will? Where did you get that statistic at? And what is it regarding? What are they trying to change America about? If it's 0.6% of people are trying to make America go back to following the Constitution, well, then yes, I would be like, yes, we should be listening to them. If 0.6% of the people are trying to say that we should get rid of the Second Amendment, well, then no, I wouldn't agree with them. So that's completely dependent on the topic. Rip Oliver, the German Shepherd Beagle mix who belonged to Angie Harmon. Oliver was shot to death by an Instacart delivery man on Easter. Oh, I would have beat that guy to death. I would have beat him till my knuckles were bloody. You need some ivermectin and an aspartame chaser. I don't have ringworm or anything like that, so I don't think I need any of that. But did we ever get clarification on RFK Jr.'s position on gun control? I never looked because I ain't voting for him. So, really considering trying to find a 92 GTS launch edition. Well, you get me one. It's just so pretty. It is. It's very pretty. Get me one. And I like, isn't it a silver frame and a black? Let me look and see before I make comments on it. I should know what I'm talking about before I make comments. That'd be a nice change. Yes, and it's the way it should be. It's a silver frame and a black slide, which is the way it should be. Because nowadays they don't do stainless. They just do a silver Cerakote on their stuff. And since the slide is already aluminum, it's anodized. So it's anodized silver. So that's fine. And the slide is just like it would be, just same bluing or whatever they normally use. And those wood grips are pretty. And I'll, you know, I'm not crazy about the fact that the safety's on the frame now. In fact, I think it looks better where it normally is. I like it better where it normally is. And I think the one on the frame looks a little bulky, a little bit of an afterthought, but I still want one. And it is a Type G. It's different though that, you know, the way you decock it is a little different, but you push up on it to decock it. But I still want one. I think Chris Snyder just bought something. Yes, he did. Chris Snyder just bought a 2024 ballot ceramic mug. That's my, I'm probably going to get in trouble for that because it's got Kermit the Frog on it. So if they ever come after me, I'll have to take that off website. But luckily, the fact that I make very few sales keeps me under the radar, I think, of a lot of people looking to get me in trouble. Oh, yeah. Shadow just sent me this picture of a sign. I actually have this sign. It's in my mom's bedroom. I got it off of Amazon. You can get these on Amazon. They got a ton of them. I got several in there. I need to get some more, though, so I can fill in some spaces. Because they make nice little just space fillers on the wall. So, yeah, I got that one. In fact, the one of him there doing this, you know, doing the, like, Hawaiian thing, I've got the one, I got a big flag out front where it's that same doing that, but he's carrying an American flag out at the opening of my driveway. What do I got all these open for? PGAR, you're telling me that revolver carries better than a semi-auto next to your kidney? Well, yes, it definitely does. Not back here on your back. That's like small back carry. No, but right here, yes, a small revolver carries better. Unless you're some sort of weirdo that's wider in the hip, like you got like a feminine build or something. But if you've got a man's build, that little notch right there is perfect place to put what do you call it? And you'll get less of a hot spot than you will with, where's my, I used to have a little graphic that I used in one of my videos. Let's see. Can I find it? I don't know how long it takes those to spool up over here. It takes them a while. let's see if I can. No, that's carry calibers. That's different. Solo. Carry. No, that ain't right. I used to have a drawing. What is that drawing? I don't know what that is. I drew a little drawing. Where'd it go? Let me see if I can. What? How did it do that? All right, I'm trying to see if I can find it under what name I can find it under, but it's not coming up. I can't find it. well, I got a video named that, but I can't find the picture. But I got a picture it illustrates. If you got any shape to you, got any masculine shape to you at all, secondary muscular development, let's show you right where to put it. John Heasley, can I use wheelers on a P226 lower or won't it stick good? And should I use a garnet or sand with like 220 grip? The lower is aluminum. Well, do you have damage you need to sand out or something, or is it just you're trying to remove an old finish to put a new finish on? You could actually, if the finish is still good, you can cover over it. If the finish you have is bad, blast it off, or just you can use chemicals to remove it also. If you don't want to damage the metal, you could use a chemical stripper. But generally, you won't have to do much of anything on that. Just coat it. As long as it's really clean. That was John Heasley, by the way. Practical Bacon used his member chat to say, if I hit the Powerball, there might be a Mateba in your future, or maybe I will just get one for myself. Asshole. That was an awful, horrible thing to say. Tease me with a Mateba. Well, I'll forgive you if you get me a Spore revolver, the Club 3.0. If you do that, I'll forgive you. Also, well, no, wait, that won't be enough to make me forgive you. You'll also have to have me a custom strong side outside waistband holster, right hand, black. Well, I'd like to use a brown one too. where am I? Michael C-3PO says, get well soon, Yank. Gravelly voice is gross and arousing in a confusing way. Well, it's not that confusing. I agree that it's arousing, but it's not confusing. Nothing confusing about it. It's rough and manly. I feel like I'm an old mountain man or something. It's been smoking hand-rolled cigarettes for 30 years. I've never even smoked. I've never been a smoker. I was raised around smokers, so I breathed a lot of smoke when I was little. But as an adult, or even as a teenager, I had no desire to start smoking because people already knew how bad it was for you. I mean, you didn't have to be a rocket scientist to figure out that this is a habit you don't want to get into. So I didn't, and I've never had to quit because I never started. So I can look at the rest of you and go, pussies, it's easy to quit because I quit. No. Just leave out the part that I never started. Madison Rodriguez said 686, 586 L comp, 19.9 comp, or a model 66. Well, the best gun in that bunch is going to be the 686 because it's stainless, which means it's the best gun configuration and it's in the best material, so you don't have to do as much care for it. Next to that will be the 586 L comp, which is actually my favorite of the two, but it's got a finish on it that would require more maintenance, so therefore I can't put it above the 686. The others would be below them, because below it in either one. I don't care, 66, 19, whatever one you like, but top choice would be 686 and then 586 L comp, and then, you know, just flip a coin for one of the other two. What is your favorite revolver on the wall behind you at the moment? Well, my favorite one, you know, that I'm like proudest of owning. Well, you know, it's usually my Korth. I'd point to my Korth and say, but I don't know. That highly engraved, wait, where is it? Right there. That highly three-dimensionally engraved Colt Python I have has got to be at the top of my list. It's just such a beautiful gun. last night, two people here were butthurt because I mentioned that Candace Owens was let go from the Daily Wire for making anti-Semitic remarks. Well, some people like Candace Owens, I guess. I don't get it. I don't like any of those political talking heads. They're all paid mouthpieces for billionaires and corporate media that wants you to think a certain way and wants to keep everybody divided and angry, because that's all they ever sell is why you should be angry, why you should be angry, why you should be angry. And I'm just like, that's what's wrong with this country now. Instead of the people coming together and working in a way to make the government work for them, they stay divided by that government who's owned by billionaires, and they don't ever get anything done. Sadly, the whacked out Instacart driver wasn't charged with a crime for shooting Angie Harmon's dog. Well, he wouldn't have been charged with a crime if it had been me, because I'd have beat him half to death. That'd probably been enough punishment. Found them for under $5. Well, that is cheap. I think they're more than that on Amazon. I think they're like $8 or something on Amazon, if I'm remembering correctly. The bearded hamster, 1979. If I'm walking with my friend and a robber pulls a gun on us and my friend grabs his gun, should I run or fight? I'd run. I don't like people all that much. I got enough friends, so I just run. Unless, of course, you know, it's like he's got the gun and you can get the bad guy around the neck to where he's going to let go. Then it might be worth it. But then I'd be afraid if I came behind him and grabbed him, if your friend got the gun away, he might shoot the guy. And it might go through him and through you both. So I don't know. I probably just, like I said, it might be smarter to just run away. Say, fuck you, buddy. Kind of like that whole, you know, you don't have to be faster than the bear. You just got to be faster than your friend kind of thing. That was Madison Rodriguez's first ever super chat on a live stream. The old finish sucks. Need to fix. Got some missing paint. Well, hey, you want to strip it off then. Strip it all down or, you know, just blast it off. A little bit of garnet blast will take it right off. And after you garnet blast it, if you want, you can take some synthetic steel wool, the 3-0 synthetic steel wool, and brush it down real good, but you don't have to. Just give you a matte black finish. Do you like the Model 29? Well, yeah, I've got a Model 29 right there, the engraved one with the fancy grips. I always like Model 29s. They're great. I've had 629s, 29s. I have a 629 right now. I have two of them, but they're performance center models. They're not like the regular, like the mountain gun or anything. Let's see, where am I at here? P-Gar said, please forgive me. I carry 10 millimeter. I get as close to revolver power as possible. Well, that does make it better, but still, 357 Magnum would be better. We are done, it looks like. I've got all the questions answered there. I've answered all the questions there. I read all the people who bought stuff. And I'm about to die. So if I don't have something come in here in a second, I'm going to look and see if I can find that thin blue line flag that he once made into a shirt. I can't remember what I did with that graphic. I'll have to rebuild it maybe. It's not hard, but it's not hard to do at all. I gotta remember what I wrote on it is the thing. Let's see. Let's see. Graphic converter. File open. Where's my desktop? Well, I don't see what I did with it. There it is, right there. Picture. Rotate clockwise. Boom. And then I will. I gotta make. Oops, shit. That ain't what I meant to do. Let's cut it off to where we can make it into a shirt design where it makes more sense. Boom. Oh, I don't know if I want to use the flag one. Do you want it to be the flag? Because I don't know if I like using the flag, because that's kind of a misuse of the flag. I could just do a thin blue line design. Well, let me know. Is it, you definitely want the flag, or do you just want a thin blue line that says what that one said? Because I kind of don't like using the flag that way. But, I mean, if I gotta, I gotta. Michael C3PO donated and said, agreed, your course and whatnot are sweet, but what good are they if you never shoot them? Yeah, well, I don't shoot that in Great Python either. It's too birdy, and I got other pythons. I got another 4-inch python. I got a 3-inch python. I got a 2.5-inch python. So I got the pythons covered. Any size canvas size, what size is it? Go to 15 width, so I can add one more stripe. Kabe B. Can I flip it? I should try to flip that, I think. Yeah, I'll try to flip that. Where am I? Ghost Shadow says, is it safe to appendix carry extra mags? I would say so. Yeah, I don't think they're going to go off. you can make the shirt what you feel it should be. Well, I will work on that tonight. I got nothing else to do. I don't feel well, so I'll work on it tonight. I just don't feel real comfortable doing the flag, because you know, I don't like desecrating the flag. excuse me. If I'm not carrying my revolvers, I carry my Glock 29 with 3 mags, just in case. Figures they will be impressed to death, LOL. What that? Figures they will be impressed to death. I don't know what that means. Does a well-shot gun end up being of similar smoothness to a trigger job that just shoots a new it can, yes. Shooting a gun a lot can smooth the trigger out a lot. whether it be the same as getting a trigger job, well, that's questionable. It could be, could not be. Could just get sloppy. But a moderate amount of shooting a trigger will make it better, usually. I mean, you're going to wear off all the little rough spots and the, because everywhere it touches, it's going to wear a little bit and get a little more finer fit. It's just, that's like I did a video comparing those SIGs that are Legion to my regular P229. And I'm like, well, the trigger on the P229, the regular one, is better. But I did add the caveat that I've got hundreds and hundreds of rounds through the regular one, whereas the Legion is relatively new. So it wasn't really a fair comparison, just one-to-one. Almost bought the blued 4-inch Colt Python, but didn't want to part with $1,700. Why not? You can get $1,700 again someday, somewhere. Rob somebody. See, if you had that Python, you could have robbed somebody. Could have made that back in a day. Feel better, sick here too in San Diego. I carry an M638 but believe in ballistic diversity. Carry what you like. Yeah, that's what I say. Carry what you like. I just found out today that the gun rights policy conference is going to be in San Diego this year. And I'm probably going to go to that. So I'll probably be down in San Diego. Wouldn't it be nice if we could actually carry guns in California by then? It's a shame the 357 SIG isn't more popular. I agree. Do you believe that RFK Jr. is one of the last few classic liberal politicians left? I don't know. I don't know what his stance is on most things. Like I say, I'm not voting on him, so I haven't looked into him. let's go ahead and do the drawing because I am fading. All right, I'm going to count the entries here. 3, 6, 9, 12, 13, 16, 19, 22, 23, 26. How many is it for 20? 26, it's 15, right? So 26 and 15, that's 41. 41, 44, 47. 50, 53, 56, 59, 62. I got to generate a number between 1 and 62. 62. I got one last one came in here. So now it's 65 because of PGAR's silly coming in here at the last minute. Thoughts on 32 mag in revolver over 38 special. when you're going from 38 special to 327 or 32 H&R or anything like that, well, then yeah, I can see where that makes sense. And I would do that if I was going to carry a 38 special. But because, you know, it's more powerful and you get more rounds. So it's a win-win. If it was a choice between 5 rounds of 357 Magnum or 6 rounds of 32 HR or 327 Federal, I'm going to take the 5 rounds of 357 Magnum. It's not worth going down to a lesser powerful round for one more round. All right, let me generate this number. 51. I got to count down 51. So that means there would be 14 below it. So let me count 14 here. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. So it would be this would be the winner. The bearded hamster is the winner. So send me an email to shootingleftofcenter@gmail.com. I don't think last night's winner did. Let me see if last night's winner sent me an email. Hat winner. I just wanted to say hat winner. Nope, I did not get one from the winner last night. So hopefully they heard last night that they won because I don't remember who it was. But tonight it is the Bearded Hamster, 1979. So send me an email to shootingleftofcenter@gmail.com. In the subject line, put hat winner. And then in the body, tell me whether you actually want a hat or you want a t-shirt or do you want a small flag and let me know which one you want, collar size, etc. And let me know your name and mailing address and I'll get that sent out to you. And that's it for us today. I know we're leaving a couple minutes early, but my voice is going on me. So two minutes ain't going to kill us. At least I showed up. We did the show. And thanks to everybody who bought merchandise to support the channel, everyone who's a channel member, everyone who's a Patreon subscriber, everyone who's a Subscribestar subscriber, everyone who does Super Chats, everyone that supports the channel financially, the ones that buy merchandise. A special thanks to all you all because you're the ones that make what we do possible. And also a special thanks to people who watch the videos, thumb them up, share them. Share them if you can. That's the best thing you can do for my videos is share them. And I appreciate that too. So thanks to everybody who does anything for the channel. I appreciate it. I will see you all again tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be our podcast. So it'll be hopefully G-Webs and Never Enough Ammo will be here. So someone go over and remind Never Enough Ammo that we're doing it tomorrow. and I'll see y'all later. Remember, always carry and stay safe until I see you again.